So today we will study about the adductor or the medial compartment of the thigh. This is the dissected specimen of the left lower limb. This one is the lateral side and here this is the medial side. Now muscles in the adductor compartment, they are pectineus and three adductor muscles, adductor longus, brevis and adductor magnus. And fifth muscle in the adductor compartment is the gracilis muscle. Now we will identify these muscles in sequence. First is this muscle, this is the pectineus muscle in the adductor compartment. Now medial to the pectineus muscle we can identify this adductor longus muscle. Once we reflect the adductor longus, we can see the short muscle, that is the adductor brevis muscle. The third adductor muscle of this compartment, it is the adductor magnus muscle. So three adductor muscles, the superficial most, adductor longus, then adductor brevis, adductor magnus muscle. The fifth muscle of the adductor compartment, it is the thin cylinder gracilis muscle. So these are the five muscles in the adductor compartment: pectineus, adductor longus, adductor brevis, adductor magnus and the gracilis muscle. Now we will study the origin and insertion of these muscles. Origin of all these muscles, it is from the pubic part of the hip bone. We will mark the origin from the hip bone only. First we will mark the origin of pectineus muscle. The pectineus, this is the left hip bone. The pectineus muscle, it will take origin from the superior ramus of the pubis, from its superior surface. So this is the pectineal or the superior surface. The pectineus muscle, it will take origin from the pectineal line and the pectineal surface of the ramus of the pubis. So this one is the first muscle of the adductor compartment, pectineus. The next muscles which we are marking are the adductor muscles. First, adductor longus muscle. The adductor longus muscle, it will take origin from the anterior surface of the body of the pubis in the angle between the pubic crest and the pubic symphysis. So this is the origin of adductor longus muscle. Next is the adductor brevis muscle. The adductor brevis muscle, it will take origin from the body of the pubis and its origin, it will extend up to the outer surface of inferior ramus of the pubis and the ramus of the ischium. The third muscle in this group, it is the adductor magnus. The adductor magnus, it will take origin from the inferior ramus of the pubis and the ramus of ischium, and its origin, it will extend up to the ischial tuberosity, up to the inferolateral part of the ischial tuberosity. This part of the adductor magnus, which is from the ischial tuberosity, this is the hamstring part of the adductor magnus muscle. Now the last muscle of this group, it is the gracilis muscle, which will take origin from the inferior ramus of the pubis, extending up to the inferior ramus, up to the ramus of the ischium. So we have marked the origins of the pectineus, adductor longus, adductor brevis, adductor magnus and the gracilis muscle from the pubic part of the hip bone. Now we will mark the insertion of these muscles. Insertion of all these muscles, they are onto the posterior border of the femur, that is the linea aspera, and up to the posterior surface of the femur, except for the gracilis muscle, which is onto the tibia bone. We will study the insertion also in the same sequence. First is this insertion of pectineus muscle, which will be inserted onto a line extending from lesser trochanter to the linea aspera. Then there is insertion of the adductor longus muscle. Here we have marked this adductor longus. The adductor longus muscle, it will be inserted onto the medial lip of the linea aspera. Then adductor brevis. The adductor brevis muscle, it will be inserted behind the pectineus and the adductor longus into the line extending from lesser trochanter up to the linea aspera. Then last muscle, that is the adductor magnus, which will have a wide insertion extending from medial margin of gluteal tuberosity then onto the linea aspera. Insertion will extend up to the medial supracondylar ridge and up to the adductor tubercle, just in the upper part of medial condyle of the femur. So this whole wide this is the insertion of the adductor magnus muscle. So these are the insertions of the muscles of adductor compartment pectineus, adductor longus, adductor brevis and adductor magnus muscle. Last muscle in this group is the gracilis muscle. This is the only muscle of the group which will be inserted onto the tibia. Here we can see this gracilis muscle which is inserted onto the upper part of medial surface of the tibia along with other two muscles which are the sartorius muscle from the anterior compartment and this is the semitendinosus muscle from the posterior compartment of the thigh. So these three muscles, sartorius, gracilis and semitendinosus, all are inserted onto upper part of medial side of the tibia and these three muscles, they are forming the guy ropes. Action of all these muscles of the adductor compartment, they are mainly helping in the adduction of the thigh, but the pectineus and the gracilis muscle, they are also helping in the flexion of the thigh. Now about the nerve supply of these muscles, before studying the nerve supply in the dissected specimen, we will just see it from this diagram. So here this is a diagram which is showing the obturator nerve. The obturator nerve is the main nerve which is supplying the adductor compartment of the thigh. Here we can see the origin of obturator nerve from the lumbar plexus. It will arise just medial to the psoas major muscle and it will enter the thigh through the obturator canal. And here it will divide into an anterior and posterior division and relation of anterior and posterior division, they can be seen by this diagram, that is the anterior division, it is lying anterior to adductor brevis muscle while posterior division it is present posterior to the adductor brevis muscle. The anterior division of the obturator nerve, it will supply the muscles, that is the pectineus and adductor longus, and it may also give nerve supply to the adductor brevis muscle. While the posterior division, it will pierce the obturator externus muscle and it will supply the obturator externus and adductor magnus muscle and it will also give may give nerve supply to the adductor brevis. The anterior division, it will also supply the gracilis muscle of the compartment. So this is a diagram which is showing the course of the obturator nerve around the adductor brevis muscle. Now this relation we can also see in the dissected specimen. In this dissected specimen, we can see this pectineus muscle and adductor longus. When we reflect the adductor longus muscle, we can see adductor brevis and along with this, we can see this anterior division of the obturator nerve which is supplying the adductor longus and pectineus and the gracilis muscle. Now posterior to this adductor brevis will lie the posterior division of the obturator nerve which will supply this adductor magnus muscle and also sometimes the adductor brevis muscle along with the obturator externus muscle. Along with the anterior division of obturator nerve, we can also see this artery, that is the medial circumflex femoral artery, a branch from the profunda femoris of femoral artery. Now another important fact about the nerve supply of the muscles in the adductor compartment is that pectineus and the adductor magnus muscle, they are having double nerve supply. That is, pectineus muscle, it is receiving the nerve supply from anterior division of obturator nerve and also from the femoral nerve by a branch nerve to pectineus. And the adductor magnus muscle, which is having an adductor and a hamstring part, so it is also receiving double nerve supply, that is from the posterior division of obturator nerve and the hamstring part, it will receive the nerve supply from the tibial part of the sciatic nerve. So these are the two muscles in the adductor compartment. One is the pectineus and the second is adductor magnus, which are having the double nerve supply. And also the muscles in the adductor compartment, that are the pectineus and the adductor longus muscle, they are forming the floor of the femoral triangle. And adductor longus muscle, its medial border, it is also forming the medial boundary of the femoral triangle. We will study about the adductor canal. This is the dissected specimen of the left lower limb, on which this is the lateral part. And here we can see the medial compartment with adductor longus and adductor magnus muscles. The adductor canal, it will extend from the apex of the femoral triangle. So here we can see the apex of femoral triangle between the sartorius and the adductor longus muscle. So this adductor canal, it will extend from the apex of the femoral triangle up to the adductor hiatus. The adductor hiatus, it is an opening in the tendon of adductor magnus muscle through which the femoral artery, it enters into the popliteal fossa as the popliteal artery. So this gap, this is named as the adductor hiatus. So extent of adductor canal, it is from the apex of femoral triangle up to the adductor hiatus. Now about the boundaries of the adductor canal. First we will see the boundaries in a simplified diagram. Here we can see the cut section of the left lower limb, in which this is the femur bone. This one is the anterior and the lateral side, and here is the medial part in which there is adductor compartment. The anterolateral wall of the adductor canal, it is formed by the vastus medialis muscle, while the posteromedial wall, it is formed by the adductor longus and adductor magnus muscle. While the roof or the medial wall, it will be formed by a fibrous sheath between the anterolateral and the posteromedial wall, and this roof will be covered over by the sartorius muscle. Now we will see these structures in the dissection. First the anterolateral wall by vastus medialis, posteromedial wall by the adductor longus muscle and adductor magnus muscle. Now here we can see in the dissection, this is the adductor canal and here is the vastus medialis muscle. This vastus medialis muscle, it will form the anterolateral boundary of the adductor canal, while the posteromedial wall, it will be formed by the adductor longus muscle above and then by the adductor magnus muscle. So here this is the adductor longus and adductor magnus muscle. While the roof or the medial wall, it is formed by a fibrous sheath between the anterolateral and the posteromedial wall. So here where this is forceps is there, this is the fibrous sheath between the anterolateral wall of the vastus medialis muscle and posteromedial wall by the adductor longus and the adductor magnus muscle. And this roof or the medial wall, it is covered over by the sartorius muscle. So just a revision of the boundaries: the anterolateral wall by the vastus medialis, posteromedial wall by the adductor longus above and adductor magnus below, and the roof, it is covered over by the sartorius muscle. Now about the contents of the adductor canal. In the adductor canal, we can see the femoral artery and the femoral vein along with obturator nerve and saphenous nerve. So once we cut this fibrous roof, we can see the contents of the adductor canal. So here we will remove this fibrous roof and to see the contents of the adductor canal. Now about the contents of the adductor canal after opening the fibrous roof. The first content under the sartorius muscle, we can see this is the saphenous nerve. The saphenous nerve, it is crossing the femoral artery from lateral to medial side. The next content which is visible here, this is the femoral artery. And third content, we can see this is the femoral vein. Now deep to the femoral vein, we can visualize this posterior division of the obturator nerve. So these are the contents of the adductor canal: saphenous nerve, femoral artery, femoral vein, and the posterior division of the obturator nerve. Now regarding the relation of these structures, the saphenous nerve, it will cross the femoral artery from lateral to medial side, and in the adductor canal, the saphenous nerve, it will run along with a saphenous branch, which is a branch from the descending genicular artery, a branch from the femoral artery in the adductor canal. So the two structures we can see, this is the saphenous nerve and saphenous branch of descending genicular artery from femoral artery. The second content, the femoral artery, it also changes its relation from the femoral triangle, where it is the lateral to femoral vein, but now it crosses the femoral vein from lateral to medial side and it becomes the medial most structure in the adductor canal. Then we can see this femoral vein. The femoral vein, it also changes its relation, being medial to the femoral artery in the femoral triangle. At the apex of the femoral triangle, it becomes posterior to the artery. And in the adductor canal, we can see that this femoral vein, it has become lateral to the femoral artery. And posterior division of the obturator nerve, it will lie deep to the femoral vein. Now, both the femoral artery and the femoral vein, they can be seen passing through this gap, that is the adductor hiatus, and they are entering into the popliteal fossa as the popliteal artery and the popliteal vein. So this gap in the tendon of adductor magnus, this is the adductor hiatus. So these are the contents of the adductor canal and the boundaries of the adductor canal.